Hello everybody, welcome to Chemistry Concept, and today we'll be discussing about hyperconjugation effect. So you know this is one of the electronic effect, very important electronic effect in organic chemistry and in inorganic chemistry also. So I'll tell you about hyperconjugation effect. What's the hyperconjugation effect is, and this is also known as Baker-Nathan effect. And I'll tell you one thing, this effect is given by one Indian scientist, Baker-Nathan. That's why it is called as Baker-Nathan effect. And what's going to happen in hyperconjugation effect? There is a donation of sigma bonded electron to the sigma star vacant orbital of corresponding or nearby atom. So this is the transition. So what is going to happen? Suppose you having a atom X here, suppose I am going to take this fluorine here and I am going to take hydrogen here, and this is the carbon and this is carbon, right? And this is the sigma bond, right? So how it will be? It will be like, suppose this will be like this one, right? If I am going to take it here, so how it will be looking like? This will be looking like this. This is fluorine and this is carbon, and this is the sigma bond, right? And here also this will be bonding like this. If you are going to talk about the antibonding, how the antibonding will be? So antibonding will be looking like because this will be bonding in that side. This is the antibonding, this is the sigma star of this CH bond, this is the sigma star of the CH bond, right? And this is the sigma of the CF bond. When this CF sigma bond electron is delocalizing over this sigma star of this CH bond, that kind of transition is known as hyperconjugation effect. And this is also known as non-bonding resonance. And this increases the stability in any molecule. So I'll tell you in a easy way what is the, suppose you may heard about this hyperconjugation effect in this way. You having any molecule and you having a positive charge here. So what is here? You having a vacant orbital here, and this is the sigma bond. So generally you used to see like this will go here and this hydrogen will knock out and you will get this fellow, and hydrogen will be knocked out. So according to you, this is the hyperconjugation effect. But what is going to happen? This is the sigma bond CH. This will be like this. This is the bonding, right? Sigma, and this is the sigma star of this CH. So what is going to happen? This CH sigma bonding electron is delocalizing over this sigma star of this CH, and due to this, what will happen? This CC bond is going to shorten, and that will decrease so much that you will feel that it is a double bond here. And this H will be knocked out as H positive ion here, and that is the hyperconjugation effect. So this is the carbon and this is the alpha carbon. So this hyperconjugation effect is directly proportional to number of alpha hydrogen. So as the number of alpha hydrogen is going to increase, hyperconjugation is going to increase, or you will get more hyperconjugative structures, and that will increase the stability. That's why tertiary carbocation is more stable than secondary than primary, because in tertiary what is going to happen? You having three hydrogen here, three hydrogen here, and three hydrogen here, total 9 alpha hydrogen. in tertiary case. In secondary case, what is going to happen? You having 6, you having, suppose this is CH3 here and CH3 here, hydrogen here. So you having 6 alpha hydrogen. In case of primary, how many alpha hydrogen you have? You have 0 alpha hydrogen. So this is the less stable. So this will follow the order like this one. That is the hyperconjugation effect in organic chemistry, and you can also apply in inorganic chemistry. And this will also going to help you in the stabilizing in ethane. Why this staggered form is more stable than the eclipsed form? So you generally think that the staggered form is more stable because of, suppose you having ethane and this is the staggered form of ethane. So generally you think this staggered is more stable than this eclipse. This is staggered form, this is the eclipse form. Generally you think this eclipse form is less stable because of repulsion. But let me tell you, this hydrogen are, this hydrogen and this hydrogen are so much far away, nearly by 3.8 angstrom. And the van der Waal radii for this hydrogen is nearly about how much? It's nearly about 2.6 angstrom something. So it is beyond van der Waal radii. So there is no attraction between this and this. So you can't say because of repulsion this is less stable and this is more stable. The reason behind the stability of this staggered form is, staggered is more stable because of hyperconjugation structure, or because of hyperconjugation. Because of effective hyperconjugation. And that is absent here. There is no effective hyperconjugation. That's why the staggered form is more stable than eclipse form. Thank you.